Hello friends, I welcome you to my YouTube channel Geography Genius led by Anshuman Mishra. So hope you have all understood the earlier video which I have just been uploaded. If you have not understood it till yet, so please write in the comment section so I can make you understand those things. First of all, before writing in the comment section, first of all you re-understand those things. If you have not understood, then also then write in the comment section so that I can make you in more easier ways and give you more good examples so that you can understand. So in our earlier video, we have talked about the Rajasthan Plain and the Indus Basin. So actually they were very small, so that the video have finished in the very, the both have been taken just video, one video of 10 minutes and it has been finished, both the parts. But now we gonna talk about the Ganga Basin. The Ganga Basin is a very important basin and one of the most largest plain of this section. So we have to talk about that in very proper manner and we have to go in brief of that. So let's talk today about that, of Ganga Basin. Let's talk about that. So as we have seen that we have talked about just in the Rajasthan Plain and Ganga Indus Basin in this section only. So we have used this map only. Now the Ganga Basin. So the importance of Ganga Basin is very much because the most important river of India and most important plain also gives this only. So this plain is actually lying towards east, or we can say they are towards east. They are generally, the slopes which are here, they are towards east. They are lying towards east. And the very good example where the pendulum leans down so that it goes there also and it goes here also. So it has both. But actually the importance of this area is very much because this area is actually the Ganga Basin and they actually go towards east. But they can, many of the times they have been recorded that they are at the, they are moving, they are straight in the directions. But yes, it is an actual and a definite that they are, the slopes are generally towards east. So this is the proper thing which I was talking about of this whole part. So this was the main thing of this which you have all understood. Now let's talk about the main thing. This is the largest part, the largest basin, we can say the largest part of Northern Plains. The largest, this actually this part, the fourth part, and this is the third part which is the largest part in the whole Northern Plain. This is covering Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and many of the part of these things, these states. So this was the actually topic which I was talking about. And this, how this originates, this plain, how does this originate? So you all must be knowing so that your grandfather and grandmother and many of your parents also going to the religious site at Haridwar, which is very famous and it is the most famous religious site of Hindus. You might be knowing that. So this Ganga River originate from where? It is very religious for Hindus. It is a most, because they treat it as their mother. So this is a very important to understand this thing. Now this actually this river is originating from Gangotri, and this you might be understand. Maybe listen to by your grandmother and your grandfather that how this this river originate from the Gangotri. So this is a very old religion story, but I will not go in that brief. But I want to tell you that this from the this river from the Gangotri originate. It originate from the Gangotri and then it goes to Haridwar place and where it goes to. And this river is very huge in length that it is forming many of the tributaries also. Like you might be knowing that there are Godavari, Ghagra, Gomati, Yamuna. All those rivers are the tributaries. You might be knowing this. And this is actually from the Chambal side, and many of the things are from the southwards also. But it does not give a lot of, we can say a lot of increasement to those areas, and not good, not that much increasement in that places. Yes. Here the soil which was depositing here, the silt which is deposited here, it is a most fertile silt, and it is also, we can say, a most fertile alluvium soil also. So the most of the fertile work has been done here because it is a most good Doab region of, as an understanding of all those things. You might have listened the name of Yamuna Doab region, which is a very famous Doab region. Because what is the Doab region? If you don't know, I want to make you understand the site which is near the river. That is the very good for the fertilization of the soil, for the fertilization of the crops, for the irrigation of the crops. So this is very fertile soil. The most fertile alluvium soil has been found in this area region, this region. So that's why it is the most famous here also. So as I have told you that there, the many other rivers which are not being told, but yet they are the major ones. So I don't want to explain it more brief, but I want to tell you that there are some rivers which people, according to the physical feature of India, they are not that much important to this Ganga basin. But I want to tell you about that. The Betwa and Son and Chambal, those are the rivers. Those are the part of this area which also little bit help in the formation of this part, the formation of Ganga basin. So this is all about that Ganga basin. We have talked about in our next part, in our next part 3, we're going to talk about Brahmaputra Valley, which is a very important, like Ganga basin, it is important, like that Brahmaputra Valley is important. So we have been talking about the one point which of Brahmaputra Valley we have talked about in the first video or a second video, I don't remember it properly, but I have told you about that. So I have told you about Ganga basin. So let's have a recap of that. Ganga basin is covering the largest part of Northern Plain. You might be knowing that, I have just told you. And many of the southward, or they are not that much important river that I have told you, Betwa, Kane, Son, all those rivers, and the most tributaries which are from here, that are Yamuna, Ghagra, Yungavari, just near Lucknow and all those areas. So these are the things which I want to talk to you about. And this, the area of this area is very fertile for alluvium soil, and many of the fertilization, the irrigation work has been done here. And the thing that they are covering, most of the areas like Madhya Pradesh is covering, Rajasthan covering, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, Bihar, and all those areas are very important for this Ganga basin, and they are the structure, they are the base of the structure of this place. So this was all about the Ganga basin. In our next video, we're going to talk about Brahmaputra Valley. Please do not forget to subscribe, like, comment view on our channel, and I will give the link of my just video which I have been just posted. And if you have not seen the on the end screen annotation, you will get that video. And on the end screen annotation, you will get my link of my channel. Please subscribe to our channel. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel, because if you subscribe, that encourages a person, and very much I encourage. Because this channel have only one motto, to just promote geography and to make you love geography. Because geography, many of the students are thinking that geography is not a good subject, but according to me, it's the best subject I have ever studied in my life. It's not that you leave all your subject and go towards one subject, but yet it's you also go for your own interest. Because it is my interest, so I'm going for the subject. So you might be interested in Hindi, you might be interested in English, you might be interested in Maths, you might be interested in Science, and you might be interested in physics, chemistry, biology. There are many interests you all have, you all might have. Every person in the study have some interest. If you like history, you will be going for that. And this channel theme is geography and history, the social studies. And after we finish the physical feature, we're gonna talk about the history, because history is very important for the NTSC. And I have just posted the three questions, the three most important questions which are here. If you can't see, if you zoom it, you can see it, but it is very not properly shown here. So this was all about this, and NTSC, we have taken a good step for NTSC. Today we have posted for three questions, and these are from the, don't you think that I have made these questions, which I have told in my earlier video, that is not my main, I have made, because it is from the guide, it is from the book, and which I have solved, and I know all the answers of this, but I want to post them in another video. So let's wait and let's see. Okay, I have said that post it in this video only, so let's post it in this video only. The Kaziranga National Park answer is very easy. The Kaziranga National Park is the question is, the Kaziranga National Park is located in which state? The Kaziranga National Park is located in Assam. Assam is a very famous place, you might be knowing that. And this Kaziranga National Park is located there only. So our next question is, which of the following country is the leading producer of copper? The option was China, India, Russia, and Chile. The answer is Chile. The answer is Chile, because it is the most copper producing country in the world, the leading producer of copper. Our next Salal hydroelectric dam is located in which state? It's very easy, it's in Uttarakhand. So it was all about this answers. So first of all, you look at that video and understand the questions. So I have told you the answers, and actually I'll tell you that why it has not. China is actually the leading producer of rice, so we have to remember that. India is the leading producer of many. It's not the most leading, but yet it is having second position, third position in many of the things, in many of the crops, in many of the irrigational crops. Russia is not that much good in the leading producers of the world, but yet it is there some of, and the copper is the child. The child is the leading producer of copper, so that was the answer. And Assam is the answer of Kaziranga, and the next is Uttarakhand. So you might be, first of all, see that video and understand the question, then only come to this video and then come to know the answers. And if you have little bit doubt to these questions, if you have little bit doubt to the NTSC examination, that how we have to give, how we have to do the things, actually we are just preparing. The channel theme is geography and history, so we will prepare for geography and history only. I want to make you remember about that point, and do not forget to press the bell icon so that you can get our video earlier. Please like, comment, share, and share it as much as you can, because many of the students will get help from this. And our channel is the first channel who is preparing for NTSC social studies part. So if you don't understand anything, please write in the comment section so that we'll make the video of that only. So as we are going ahead for the finishing our physical feature of this Northern Plain, so we will be making, as you all know that we are making amazing points, but today, but after this video, we're gonna make of Asia. We will talk about Asia. That will be only one video and it will be large video. We'll be talking about Asia country and what is the total length and width, and we will talk about in another video. We will not go out of the way. And this was all about that. And the amazing point will be this only, after this video finishes. So our one point is left, that is Brahmaputra Valley. In my next video, I'm going to explain it very properly. So if you don't understand anything, please write in the comment section. Thanks for watching.